In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a retro comic book effect in Photoshop. Hey everyone, welcome back to the Photoshop Training Channel. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at jrfrompTC. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to combine filters and smart objects to create a retro comic book effect. This effect is going to be non-destructive, which means that you can always come back and make adjustments to the effect. Also, you can use this as a template so that you can simply swap in files and apply the effect to a new image. Okay, let's get started. We're going to work with this image here. This is an Adobe stock image, but of course you can use any image that you like. This effect works better with a white background. You can extract your foreground element from the background if you like, or you can keep the background since it does work with images with a background. But anyway, so we have this image here, and the first step is to convert this into a smart object. So I'm going to right click on the layer and select convert to smart object. This effect is going to be non-destructive. So that's the goal of this tutorial, to create a convincing comic book effect and keep things non-destructive so that we could always come back and edit the adjustments or even replace the original image with a different image and have the same effects apply to it. So now that it's a smart object, I can go into filter, filter gallery, and we're looking for this filter here titled poster edges under artistic. And one thing I'm going to mention right off the bat is that these values that I input into these filters are for my image. Obviously, if you're using a different image, the values may be different. So look more at the effect and not so much at the values. You can use the values that I input as a starting point. So I'm going to get started with the edge thickness. So I can adjust that accordingly. And I'm looking for an edge about this thick. 4 for me. Edge intensity controls the intensity of that edge. 1 will work. And posterization, I think I want a little bit more than that at 4. If I were to leave it at 0, then you get that effect there. 4 makes it pretty flat, which is what I want. And I'm going to press OK. So that's the result that I got. I'm going to go back into the filter menu. And I'm going to go back into filter gallery. This time I'm going to select film grain. And I'm going to use a grain of about 4. And I'm going to increase the highlight area all the way to the right to 20 to create this flat looking effect. And for intensity, I'm going to reduce it down to 6. So this is the effect that I have now. I'm going to press OK. And notice that in my smart object, we're building up on those filters. Now I'm going to go back into filter, pixelate, color halftone. This filter doesn't have a preview, so you can just start with the values that I'm going to use and see if they match my image. If not, you can make adjustments to try to match them. More likely than not, the value that you're going to end up changing the most is going to be the pixel size. So I'm going to start out with 4 pixels. Channels 1 through 4 are 110, 160, 90, and 45. And I'm going to press OK. The advantage of using smart objects, not only is it that we can come back and edit those filters, but we get these icons here to the right of the smart filter. In this case, under color halftone, if we double click on that icon, you'll get this window that allows you to reduce the opacity of the filter and also change the blending mode. So we can change the blending mode to soft light, and you'll see that effect there. Now that halftone effect is applied to the original effect that we had. You could also press P on the keyboard to disable the preview, P to bring it back, or you can just click on the checkbox. And that keyboard shortcut works for all windows that have this preview checkbox. Just remember to press the P key and press OK when you're done, of course. So that's the effect that we have so far. Now we're going to work in making the outlines a little thicker and more noticeable. So what I'm going to do is select the smart object that we're working with, and I'm going to press Control J, that's Command J on the Mac to duplicate it. Then I'm going to right click on smart filters and click on clear smart filters. So that brings back the original image. Then I can go into filter, filter gallery, stylize glowing edges, and that's the effect that I get. You're going to have to use your imagination at this point. Imagine that these bright lines are black and that the background is white, and that's how we're going to apply those lines onto the background in the next step. But for now, just control your edge with your brightness and smoothness and just look at the overall thicker lines that will be black eventually. We're going to press OK when we're done. Then I'm going to go into Image, Adjustments, Black and White to turn those pixels white so it removes the color and press OK. If you're using an older version of Photoshop, something that is not CC, you won't be able to apply that adjustment directly onto the smart object. So you can just right-click on the layer, rasterize it, and then you will have to work destructively, unfortunately. But anyway, at this point, we need to invert the pixels to make the white pixels black and the black pixels white. Press Ctrl-I, Command-I on the Mac to invert. Then we need to make these lines a bit darker. So go into Image, Adjustment, Levels, and drag the black point to the right. And keep dragging that midpoint to the right. And the white point, drag it to the left. So we're mainly worried about the outline here. And press OK. Now we're going to use a blending mode to blend these layers together. So I'm going to change the blending mode from normal to multiply. Multiply reveals dark pixels and hides bright pixels. I don't want the entire layer to affect my composition. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold Alt Option on the Mac and click on the layer mask icon to make a layer mask that is black, which hides all the contents of the layer. Now I can paint with white using the brush tool, and I can selectively bring back some of that detail. I'm going to use the right bracket key on the keyboard to increase the size of my brush, and I'm going to paint on the edges to bring that outline back. I think I want it almost in the entire drawing. I just do not want it on his face, and you'll see why in a moment. And the reason I don't want it in his face is because I don't think those lines look very good. So I can go ahead and undo that. And maybe paint in just a little bit on the lips, because I did like that effect on the lips. So maybe something like this. So you can decide where you want to paint and where you don't want to paint. At this point, we have a very convincing comic book look. If I double tap on the zoom tool, you'll see the image at 100%. I'm going to hold the space bar to pan around the image so that you can see it better. And that's our effect. Now we're going to work on coloring the background and changing the color of his shirt. I'm going to double click on the hand tool once again. First, we need to select our model here. So I'm going to disable this top layer and disable the visibility of the smart filters. So we're back with the original image. With that layer 0 selected, which is our original layer, I'm going to select the quick selection tool and click and drag around his body to make a selection. And the selection doesn't need to be perfect. We just need to make sure that it covers his entire body. I'm going to hold Alt Option on the Mac and click and drag in between his arms and also in between his finger to deselect those pixels. With that layer active, I can now enable the smart filters, enable the second layer, and I'm going to collapse those filters just so that we have a little more room to work with. And I'm going to create a solid color. And I'm going to make a blue solid color. And the blue that I want is roughly this one. It's not that important right now. We can always come back and change it. So I'm going to press OK. But I want the blue to be outside of his body, not covering his body. So I'm going to click on the layer mask. And I can either press Ctrl-I, Command-I on the Mac. Or I can click on this invert button in the properties panel for that layer mask. If I click on invert, now you'll get the background. Then I'm going to change the blending mode to multiply. And those black outlines around his body come back. So that's before and after. We can do something very similar with his shirt. So I'm just going to disable the smart filters on that original layer. And I'm going to select the quick selection tool. And I'm going to select his shirt. And again, you don't have to be very precise. Something like this. And I accidentally selected the jeans. So I'm going to hold Alt Option on the Mac and remove some of the pixels from the bottom part of his body, like right here, and then create a new solid color, and we're gonna want an orange color, so something like that. Press OK, change the blending mode to multiply, and it gets applied to that layer. I'm gonna bring back the smart filters, and the effect is reapplied. At this point, you can decide to keep the colors that you chose or change them if you want. So I can double click on the blue and click and drag and change the color if need be. And I can do the same thing for the shirt. Maybe I want a blue shirt, green shirt, yellow shirt, it really doesn't matter what color you want, that color would be applied. I'll stick with orange. At this point, you can adjust the colors of the image. So you can create something like a vibrance adjustment layer and just increase the vibrance. So that's before and after. It's a subtle effect, but I think it works. It mainly works on his face. Before and after. You can also maybe increase the saturation a little bit and go into curves and maybe give it a little bit of contrast. And actually, I'm going to drag the curves adjustment layer below those colors so it affects the original values, not these colors. I'm going to click on the shirt color and slightly reduce the opacity. I want to get some of that halftone back. And as the last step, I'm going to create a new layer, select the brush tool, paint with black, and make sure that you have a hardness of 100%. And it works better if you have a Wacom tablet, but you can come into your Wacom tablet and you can start painting in some of those areas to make it a little more realistic. So you can zoom in and just work on areas that you think need more of a manual touch. Like so. Maybe you can come in and fill in the lips, add a line that comes off his nostril there, and just start adjusting the image accordingly. You could also create a new layer and fill in the white of the eye. And maybe give the eyeball a highlight. Like so, and I can double tap on the hand tool and you see what that looks like. That might be a little too much, so I'm just going to bring down the opacity to about something like that. And I'm still not liking the brightness of that right eye, so I can always go and just make a selection out of that highlight and just hit the delete key on the keyboard and it removes it. And I'm actually going to zoom in and try again. So I'm going to paint with white on that area there. And I think that looks much better. Now, if you wanted to, you could always double click on the smart object to come in and make adjustments to the original image. So another thing that you can do is, instead of applying the shirt color effect after the fact, we can do it before. So if I delete this layer and come back into the smart object and make a selection. I'm just going to do this fairly quickly here. You can do the same thing. Go to solid color. Select a orange color like that one. Change the blending mode to multiply. And once you close this file and save it, that same effect will be applied. The advantage is now that we get a lot more of the halftone, and that looks much better in my opinion. So you can do it either way, whatever works best in your image. And also, if we double click on any of the smart objects and it brings that up, we can actually bring in a different image, maybe her, drop her in here. And obviously it's not going to look perfect because we did have some custom layers there, but if I disable all those custom layers, we can see that we apply the comic book effect to her as well. So that will be a quick way of creating sort of like a template that you can apply the comic book effect to and then come in and adjust all the other layers accordingly, of course. For now, I'm just going to delete this layer because that's not what I want to do. Save it by closing it and clicking yes. And then I have all these other layers. Something that helps a lot, and I haven't done too much of that in this video, is just going through the drawing with your hand and just making those manual adjustments that I think add a lot to the drawing. So you can spend a little more time in your image making those manual adjustments. And by the way, if you decide to create an image using this tutorial, don't forget to share it on Instagram with the hashtag PTCVids. I often look for that hashtag to see what you're all up to. And that's it for this tutorial. If this is your first time at the Photoshop Training Channel, don't forget to click on the subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching, and I will talk to you again next time.